brother Aseer, through the tears. He's a real historian, a real element of understanding this information. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to him. And remember, everybody stay attentive. This is information that you guys need to know for yourself and for the future.
All right. Let's go around the room real quick. See everybody, where everybody from. Where you from, Stacey?
Haiti.
Haiti. All right, so your nationality, where you from? You were born in Haiti, you were born in America?
In Haiti.
In Haiti. So your nationality would be Haitian. What about you, Stacey? Same? Okay, let me make it quick. How many of you from Haiti?
Raise your hand.
Raise your hand up.
Okay, how many people are from somewhere else? Name another island, another place. Where at?
Bahamas,
okay. Where at? Where else? Bahamas. Anybody else? Thanks, bro.
Jamaica.
All right. Where else?
Africa.
What part? How you doing? You saying Africa? Come on, man.
Where you from?
I'm from over here, but I'm Haitian.
Speak loud, fam. I can't hear you.
I'm from over here.
Over here. So that would be what? America, Florida.
Florida.
Sunrise, what?
Florida.
Florida. Okay, so you said Jamaica, right? Okay. That's what we know it as in English. You know what it is in the name that your ancestors called it? What it was before it was Jamaica? Has anybody ever thought about what your spot was prior to what you know it is now? Where y'all from? Guatemala, right? Guatemala, fancy. Do you know what Guatemala was called prior to Guatemala? You remember? Your ancestors told you, your people told you? I can't hear you. You don't know? Okay, well, Jamaica, for instance, used to be called Mica. Guatemala used to be called Orucan. Yeah. Funny, right? What language do you think that is? What language do you think that is?
Spanish.
What language?
Spanish.
Say again?
Spanish?
No, this is before Spanish. When did people start speaking Spanish? Do you know?
No. Was that Egyptian?
You close. How old do you think Spanish as a language is? For instance, since we speak. How old do you think it is?
About 200 years.
Close. Where do you think Spain is? If I was to say, okay, well, where's Spain? If I was to say, okay, let's get on a plane, go to Spain right now. Where are we going?
Europe.
Italy is one. I said Spain. You're saying Italy. You think Italy and Spain is the same thing?
Yeah.
Oh, my brothers and sisters, we got work to do. Look. Okay. Spain, right? Spain used to be called, well, España, right? That's what it is in Spanish, right? But that's not what it is. When I ask you how old you think Spanish is, what I'm asking you really is how old is the language that you think that you speak and how long you think you can speak it? Like, you speak French, right? Well, Haitian people speak French, correct? Mm-hmm. But there's a place called France, and they speak French too, right? Mm-hmm. Then there's another place called Belgium, and they speak French, right? But are Belgian people Haitian people? Are Haitian people French people?
No.
Okay, but French people also speak Creole, right? Mm-hmm. So if they speak Creole, then are Creole people Haitian people? Not necessarily, but there's a relation, right?
Yes.
A relationship with Creole and Haitian, right?
Yes.
And where does that relationship come from?
Ancestors?
Yes. But specifically, let's say geographically speaking, where? Haiti, right? So we got Haiti over here. Then we have Louisiana, right? That area. Then we have another place called France. Then we got another place called Belgium, right? For instance, right? But then they also speak French in Mali. They speak French in Burkina Faso. They speak French a lot to the people. But that doesn't mean that all of those people are French, right? So, when I ask you how old English is, really, or how old Spanish is, really what I'm asking you to think about is how long have you been speaking what it is they told you that you've been speaking? Because we just speak in this language, like they say, okay, English, that's a slave language, right? Like, we got slave names, that's what they've been telling us, right? Mm-hmm. We speak in English, we speak in the slave master's language, right? Have y'all heard that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Wow, so y'all millennials, that's like maybe my generation. Let me regroup. Okay, when you hear them talk about slavery, mm-hmm. right? That comes up a lot whenever race come up, right? Mm-hmm. It seems like whenever they start talking about race, or you look like us, the first thing they bring up is this word slave, right? Now, the problem with them calling you have an eraser? You have an eraser? Okay. The problem with you being referred to as a slave is the fact that you could never be a slave. The reason why you can never be a slave is because the term slave has nothing to do with people of your complexion or your hue. The term slave comes from a Polish word called to Slav, right? Or Slav. This is where the term slave actually comes from. And the Slav comes from a people called the Slovak, right? Slovakia, right? So, are any of y'all from Slovakia? Do any of y'all know what Slovakia is?
I heard of it.
Okay, when you heard it, where did you hear it was?
On TV.
That's true. I can't hate on you. That's true. Well, Slovakia or Slovenia is in a place called the steppes of central, or excuse me, far western Europe, where it's very, very cold. Where really, at the time now, there's really nobody that looked like you phenotypically there. So if that's the case, do any of y'all, have anybody in your family ever told y'all that y'all had Slovenian in your family?
No.
No. So if you didn't have any Slovenian in your family, that means you could not be a Slav, right? Mm-hmm. So if you can't be a Slav, and the term Slav or slave means Slovenian, how could any of you be a slave? Mm-hmm. If I was to call you an orange right now, would you answer to being an orange? Would you accept, oh, I'm an orange today? No. If I called you, if I said that your name, what's your name? Caillou? Okay, let's say your name is Caillou, and I start calling you Albert, right? You are Caillou so long as you don't, you are Caillou so long as you don't answer to Albert. You understand what I'm saying? So you notice in our generations, we get older and stuff like that. When you're grown up, they have things where you have like nicknames, and we start calling ourselves different names. Or like, you know, you grow up and you go through a phase where you don't like your name, so you want to be called something else, right? The problem with that is that was something that was taught to our people to get us to forget our ancestry, who we come from. See, the problem is that they got all of us thinking that we are individual islands. When I say they, I'm talking about every educational system that has existed from the time that our ancestors came to this place. But when I say came to this place, I don't mean that they got on a boat and came and took you from someplace and brought you someplace else. If you believe that, right, the story is that nobody was here, and one day somebody came here with some boats, and with three boats, they killed over 100 million people from Alaska to Chile. Now, if that's the case, there would really be nobody here on this landmass right now, because everybody would be wiped out. Also, if you look at something called the Atlas, right? Y'all know what an Atlas is, right? Mm-hmm. Y'all know what an atlas is, right?
No.
Y'all don't know what an atlas is. Okay, an atlas is something that you look at in a book that shows you the proximity or how many people are in a given area or given country.
Who said a map? Who said a map?
Mr. Eugene.
Jesus.
Inshallah. A map, though, is a little different. A map is basically showing you how to get to the different places. An atlas is actually going to break down exactly what the landmass is like, who the people are, what they eat, what they look like, what they wear, blah, blah, blah. The problem is, for your whole life, you've been seeing images of other people dressing up like you, and therefore you become disinterested because you don't see yourself in anything. Every time you look at Game of Thrones, every time you look at the TV, the only time you see our people on TV doing something of significance is when we're backing up some other races.
Message to the youth.